Hey guys, it's me again, Bill over at Whole Life Soaps. And in an earlier video, I was showing you some golden sun embeds that I have made that I'm going to put in a bar of soap. So those are done. They're sitting right here in this basket. I used a skewer to dip them in to some melt and pour glycerin soap. And then I'd set them out here, and I was going to put the whole side down, but they stuck to the table a little. So I just took that part off. I'll put that part in. I just covered the hole up with my finger, but they look good. So step one is done. Step two is to get my stars that are going to go on top. And so I have in here a layer of white soap that I've made. It's a very thin layer, so I gotta be kind of careful. But I poured this yesterday so that I can work with it today. And I have a fruit cutter. It's just one of those shapes you can buy, cut shapes into fruit for kids or for design. And I'm just gonna punch a bunch of holes in the shape of my stars and get them out in one piece. Just like that, I'm gonna have stars, ladies and gentlemen. Sweet. Let me just do this. I'm hoping I get 124. If not, I'll make more. Sometimes when you have an idea, you gotta plan ahead. And because things like this take time, I couldn't just do this on the day that I'm gonna make the soap. I gotta have it all kind of ready and cured ahead of time. Nice day here in Rywood. Got the door open, so here's the traffic problem. Because we are open for business, so they do this. People come in, I'll stop. I'm going to want to call this bar of soap yet. It's going to be scented with white tea and ginger. It's a bramberry scent. It's very nice. I don't get paid by Brambleberry. I do like their products though. I own a lot of their molds. When I first started, I used their slab mold. That's what this is. I only use it for special projects now, but it's good stuff. If you're just a small batch soap maker, you can't go wrong with them. I make on a larger scale, but it's okay. Somebody walks in, I will pause the video, guys. I may pause it anyway, it's gonna take a while. But I know people like to watch this kind of stuff, so. It's like a soap fetish. It cracks me up. Thank you. pause this. I'll come back when I'm done. All right, folks, I've got 62 stars here. I'm going to cut some moons now. I'm going to actually get rid of some of this excess. We're going to use that again in a minute. I'm not done with it. I'm going to need it. But I don't actually have a moon shape. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut circles. And from the circle, create a moon. So I will just go back through like that and make my moon. About 32 moons. So again, it's going to take a little while. When I run out of this soap here, I'm going to mash that down and repurpose it into moons. Just made this soap yesterday, so it's really good and soft, just how you want it for this kind of a project. It was too hard, it'd be too hard to cut. The stars would probably be okay, but I think it'd be too hard to cut the moons and get it done cleanly. I'm just using the bottom of one of these shapes to make this, but you know, you could use a bottle cap, like from a water bottle if you wanted to. You just have to make sure that there's a way to punch the soap out. Like you have to put a hole in it or something so you get the soap out of the mold itself. Soapers are like engineers, they have to find ways to fix problems or solve how to make what they gotta do. They don't have the shape to do it. I got a soap I'm gonna be using Pringle cans for. So Okay, so now, got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I got 13, I got to make 64 moons. Well, at least 32. At least enough for one batch or so. Let's get this going. Just like dough, when it's soft, you can use it again. Probably won't get all I need out of this batch. I'll probably have to make another, but that's okay. Do the best I can with what I got. Press that out. Don't want to make it too thin. If you find that your soap starts to stick to your mold because it's getting too soft, which it's starting to do, you could always coat the inside with a little bit of castor oil. I don't like to do that because I feel like I'm going to add additional oil to the soap, and when I actually embed these in something else, I always worry about a pocket forming around it. So I don't personally do that, but I've read that you can do that. folks. So sorry, I had to stop the video for a second. I had a bunch of customers come in and help them. And then I started to finish my moons and forgot to restart the camera, but I'll show you what I did. Okay. So I had that soap. I used all of it and I cut out stars with this star fruit cutter, and I cut out moons by cutting out a whole circle and then cutting out a half of it to create that moon effect. Then of course we have our golden suns, right? So the concept is it's going to be a star, a sun, and a moon embedded into the top of the soap, and the top of the soap will likely be black or maybe deep purple. I haven't decided yet, but that's the goal. So thanks for watching. This is part two of making my sun, moon, and star bar. So part three, we'll go through the actual soap process. Thanks.